so hot. Ah! It is so hot. I'm like sweating. Hey everyone, how are you guys? Welcome to another video. I have not done a sit down, talk to you face to face video in a while. So in this video, I do want to give you guys a little bit of an update, what I've been up to, like where I've been, where my head's been, and I also want to share some things that I picked up recently for fall. So this is just a combination of, you know, where I've been and also a fall haul. If any of that interests you, stick around, stay tuned. If you guys are new to my channel, welcome. This is my first video back, so if I'm awkward, it's just I'm not used to this yet. It's been several months and anyway, if you enjoy my content, I would really appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel, give this video a thumbs up, and if you want to, you can follow me on Instagram to keep up with me personally. I do have a TikTok and Instagram and, you know, do little, like, makeup transitions and stuff over there. Alright, so I'm gonna first talk about where I've been. I'm gonna try to keep this short and sweet because I'm thinking about doing a full-out sit-down talk through video about it if you guys are interested. If you guys are only here for the haul portion, I totally understand and you can skip forward to that. All right, so really quick, where have I been? Again, it's been several months and I'm gonna be completely raw and candid with you guys. And I feel like I typically don't do this because I've said this several times over the past years of me just being on YouTube that I don't often like to, you know, record when I'm like not feeling well or if I'm down, because I don't want to bring negativity to the channel, to you guys. I don't want to bring negative energy. For the most part, my channel has been very lightweight, very carefree, very, you know, just shopping, hauls, makeup, and some dating, you know, series here and there, and vlogs. So I try to keep it as positive as possible and entertaining. Recently, you guys know, I've been doing a lot of budgeting videos and I try to be educational as well as entertaining and all the other things I just listed, but I realized over the past few months, like being off camera and like not showing my face, that, you know, talking about the hard times and the hardships and the struggles can also be very helpful to people as well. I think I'm ready to like open up a little bit more and share a little bit more than I have. So perfect timing, because the other day was Mental Health Awareness Day, which I believe is October 10th. I'm filming this on October 11th. I'm not sure when this is gonna go up. So it was just yesterday, and I feel like mental health, it's starting to become not so much of a taboo topic, because after 2020 with COVID and the pandemic and all of that, I think everybody has some sort of struggle with mental health in some capacity, and I think it looks different on everybody. So my mental health has been like shot. And, you know, I still film videos and I do have good days, but like more often than none, recently my days have not been good. If you guys hear city noises, there's always sirens and airplanes and helicopters, so I live in the city and my windows are open. So just over the past few months, I realized that my mental health is not good. It's not in a good place, and I realized I do have, you know, a form of depression, because I just haven't felt like myself. And depression looks differently for everyone, and I'm not a professional. I'm just sharing my experience. I truly think it's depression. You know, I have days or like long stretches of days where I just don't want to talk to anybody. I don't want to interact with anybody. And, you know, I have days where I just like sit around and I'm just so tired and I don't want to do anything. And then you have those days where you like are in your head and you're like, should I be doing more? Am I doing enough? I'm 30 years old and I'm single. Like, what's wrong with me type of thing? Like, it just like, it's like a roller coaster. So I'm trying my best to like take control of it. And I usually get emotional, so I'm gonna try not to get emotional here, even though like I feel it coming on. But yeah, that's just kind of where I've been, and I just want to bring awareness to it, because if you guys go through anything like that, it's a lot of people go through it, including myself. And so I think for me, just talking about it, it might be therapeutic, and hopefully it can help one of you or anything like that. But I can go into more detail about that in another video if you guys are interested. Just, you know, that, and then family stuff, and then dating. Ugh, you guys, dating, it's just not the vibe. That's kind of where I've been. I don't want to talk too much because I've already been talking for way too long. Let's get into the fun stuff, and I'm going to show you guys what I picked up recently for the fall. All right, I'm going to start off with the one and only makeup item that I have here. I have not been purchasing makeup lately, you guys. I just have been using the same things. I've been trying to go through my makeup collection, because if you've been following me for a while, you know my makeup collection is very large. So I did pick this up recently, though. It's by Buxom. It's one of their new shades in their full-on lip plumping polishes. This color is Vivian Vanilla, and it's a beautiful, I don't know, like a deep burgundy bronze shade. I have it on my lips right now. I'm gonna put a little bit more on just so you guys have a better idea. But it is a gloss, but it has really good color to it. It's plumping as well. It has a beautiful shine to it. Only thing that I'm not a huge fan of is that this collection, it's their fall collection, okay? So the scent of this is like a pumpkin spice scent. So if you are not a fan of pumpkin spice, you might not like the smell of this, but I really do like it. It's different from my everyday nude, so highly recommend, and I got mine at Ulta. The next thing I'm going to show you is kind of random, but I did pick this up recently, and they are new headphones. I do have Apple AirPods, but mine recently stopped working, and they are barely a year old. I think just a little over a year old, so I got to try to like figure out what's wrong with them or reset them or whatever. But I have been wanting to pick up Beats headphones for some time now. These are the wireless headphones, and I got mine in the all black, so they look like this, and they are super comfortable. They are noise canceling. They do have several colors, but I liked the all black, of course, because I'm very simple, and for the most part. But yeah, love these. Again, super noise canceling. I wear them at the gym all the time. These are great. They are a little bit pricey, but the quality is up there. I think they're like $300 for these particular ones. I got mine off Mercari, and I had like a credit, so these were basically free because I sell stuff on Mercari. But love these. Highly recommend them if you're looking for a noise canceling headphone. Okay, the next thing I want to show you guys are some sunglasses. Now, these are technically summer sunglasses or summer shades and colorways, but I did pick these up at the end of summer, and I just never got a chance to show them to you. So I really wanted to show them to you because they do have these particular styles in different colors if you want to pick them up. So these are by the brand DEZI, which is by DEZI Perkins, who is a beauty guru, influencer type of thing. I follow her on Instagram, and I think she is one of my favorite YouTubers and influencers because she's just very real, raw, down to earth. She's a beautiful Latina girl. I just love her and her products. So the first pair that I got, I don't remember the names of these. I will leave them on the screen or linked down below, but I believe these are called the 2000s. As you can see, they are in like this orange colorway. If you follow me on Instagram, I did take a bomb ass picture, if I do say so myself, wearing these outside, and I took that picture by myself too. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go on my Instagram. The picture of me in my sneakers and wearing these, I took that picture by myself. I was so proud. So these are the 2000s. They are a like transparent orange color. They are a larger square shape, very 2000s-esque, like 2003, very J-Lo type of moment. Again, these are in the limited edition like orange shade, so I don't believe these are available anymore, but she has other colors in the same style, so love these. I believe every pair is $85, comes in a beautiful case with a little dust case. Yeah, dust bag. So I got those. And then these, I was kind of disappointed in. I wanted to love them, but I have like a rounder, I guess wider face. So they are a little bit tight on me. Same case, and this is in the limited edition color as well. It's this beautiful green. I thought these were so cool. I loved the color. I am kind of disappointed in the style. I probably should have gotten this in a different style, but here we are. Again, I will leave the names on the screen, but that is what this pair looks like. Again, love the color. These are a little tight on my face, so kind of bummed about that, but it's okay. And yeah, great quality, nice weight to them. Highly recommend DEZI sunglasses. Again, I just probably should have got a different style. Let's move on to some clothing items. I have all my clothes over here, which is why I'm looking over here, but I'll start off with the flannel that I'm wearing. I'm wearing this like green and blue flannel shirt. It's an oversized flannel, and y'all, it has a hood. So I really like that it has a hood. I think it just gives it a little bit more. And I actually got this, I think, at Marshall's. If you are looking for oversized flannels for the fall, I highly recommend TJ Maxx, Marshall's, all of that. Even Ross. Ross has been really kind of like on point for like fast fashion. So if you want something affordable, I got this at Marshall's, I believe. I believe this was like $13 or $15, super affordable. So highly recommend those stores. The next thing I'm gonna show you guys, I actually got one at Nordstrom Rack and one at TJ Maxx. So I first went to Nordstrom Rack and I saw this top, and I am very particular with my little like crop tops. This is technically a sports bra, and I kept the tag on this one to show you guys the brand. The brand of this is Kyodan, K-Y-O-D-A-N, and this is the Ultra Soft collection, and it is just a sports bra that is also like a crop top. And the bra portion ends about here. So you have about like three, is this like, probably like 4 to 5 inches of fabric under the bra. And it's great because it is a sports bra, so it has some support. It does, again, have some like cups in here as well, which are removable. You can take them out if you're not a fan. But I got it in this beautiful like burnt orange color, and mine is in a large. Oh, I'm sorry, the color of this is hot chocolate. I don't know if I would call this hot chocolate, but that's what the tag says. And this was $14.97. And then I found the same top, same brand, $14.99. So the same price pretty much at TJ Maxx. And I found it in this beautiful like gray color. So again, they're technically sports bras. I wear them, you know, with biker shorts and a flannel. Like I'll wear it with something like this. And it's just super comfortable. And again, it's a sports bra, so it has support for my girls. And yeah, I really like it. A little longer than a normal sports bra again. So found those and I highly recommend them. So comfortable if you have a bigger chest. Love it. Okay, so before I forget, because these were on the floor, I'm gonna show you the one pair. Actually, I have two pairs of shoes I'm gonna show you. But these have been my absolute favorite. Fall just started and it's getting cooler here in Philadelphia. So I wanted a pair of platform boots for the fall, and I got these off of Nordstrom and love them. So I've already worn them, so you guys can see that they are kind of like crinkled. These are by the brand Jessica Simpson, and it says leather upper. So I'll leave it linked down below. I don't know if it's real leather or like, you know, vegan leather or whatever. It does have a zipper on the inside, which is nice. It has a decent size opening for your ankle, which is great as well. And they come a little higher than the ankle, just a heads up. So you do kind of have to break them in and like, you know, wear them in a little bit. But I love the squared toe, y'all. Square toe is very in, and with the nice platform, they're fairly comfortable. I have walked around in them for a few hours, and they do kind of hurt towards the end of the night, but for the majority of their night, they're pretty comfortable. I love also this heel, how it's shaped. super chunky. But yeah, I will leave these linked down below. I think they are a great addition to a fall wardrobe. I haven't purchased a black booty in a while, so I was really excited to get these, and I'm really excited that I actually enjoy them. Okay, the next pair of shoes I'm going to show you, I don't know if they're really fall, but I feel like you can't go wrong with an all-white sneaker. If you guys have been watching me since summertime, I have been looking for a pair of all-white sneakers for a while to purchase, and I just haven't found anything that I liked, and I typically like to see it in person and try them on in stores. So I ended up finding these in store, and they are by Nike, and these are the Huaraches. Not really exactly sure how to pronounce it, but I will leave the name on the screen. I think they're super cute. They're kind of like that trendy, chunkier sole, as you guys can see, and it kind of goes out and then comes back in instead of just like a straight down. But yeah, a chunky sole, all white, super comfortable. These do run very, very small. I had to size up in this to an 8. I sized up an entire size, okay? So I usually typically wear a 7. I tried on the 7. It was like deathly tight. And then the associate at Nike was like, oh, these run so small. So I sized up an entire size. These are an 8. And I think they're really cute. I haven't worn them yet, though. So I'm just like, should I return these? Like, I don't have a pair of all-white sneakers. And I just thought those were cute. But let me know if you guys like them, if I should keep them, or if I should return them. All right, you guys, I do have a few other things to show you, but this video is already pretty long, so I'm actually going to cut the haul here. If you're interested in seeing the other like clothing items that I picked up, let me know and I can do another haul video in a little bit. I just don't want this video to be too long because I know some people don't like long videos. But I really appreciate you guys making it through the entire video if you got this far. And I hope me opening up is something that you guys are okay with. I know it's different content than what I usually go for, but obviously I'm gonna do my best to make it carefree and lightweight and still entertaining while, you know, being, you know, a little bit more vulnerable, I guess you could say. But yeah, let me know if you guys are interested in seeing videos like that where I kind of just talk about like mental health, what I'm going through, just my thoughts. I am going to be doing dating videos again. I know you guys are really excited about that, so those will be coming. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, if you want more hauls, let me know. I love me a good haul, and I appreciate you guys. Please subscribe if you haven't. Give this video a thumbs up, follow me on Instagram, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!